named Darius Milhaud, called Le Création du Monde, which means the creation of the world. And this is a wonderful piece. It's actually a ballet. And there's a connection here between this piece and the first piece we played, and let me get my notes. So, the connection is that this ballet was premiered for the Ballet Suédois, and if you remember, that is also the place where Georges Antheil made his career, his debut in Paris. Now, Milhaud was a very well-established composer by the time this came about. He's actually quite prolific, but everybody in Paris in the 20s was crazy about jazz, and Milhaud, more than anybody else in some ways, he was kind of a musical minor bird. He traveled a lot. He spent time during World War I in Brazil as an attaché, and so he produced several pieces that were about Rio, and he wrote, so he spent time in the United States, so we have Kentuckiana, about Kentucky, and so he loved jazz, and he went to the United States, and he was in New York, and he went to Harlem, and he heard real jazz, real American jazz for the first time, which of course was just ragtime, and it totally influenced him, and this piece comes out of that. And actually the instrumentation, which is kind of unusual, it comes from what was called a variety band, and he heard this exact instrumentation in a show called Liza that he heard in Harlem, and so that was the inspiration for this combination of instruments. And the ballet is based on an African legend of the creation of the world. And it was premiered in 1923. And the ballet begins with three African gods of creation on the stage. And they're conjuring up trees and animals into beings with rituals and spells. Male and female dancers emerged as the deities creating humankind. The ballet ended with a solitary couple left on stage after the group dances represent desire and mating. So this is all in this music, so you can use your imagination. It's a very exotic French jazz creation of how the world started. And one other thing about Milhaud that I found very interesting, so in the 40s, you know, things were not good in Paris if you were a radical and a Jew, so he came to the United States and he taught for over, 20 years at Mills College in California, and he had several famous students who helped propagate his works, and they are William Bolcom, the wonderful American composer, and Dave Brubeck, the jazz pianist. So, very interesting music, beautiful composition, we hope you enjoy.